Hello everybody, this is Chris. Well, to change the registry on a ship might be harder on some models than others, but it's fairly straightforward regardless. Alright, to do create a new registry, first of all you need to make sure you have the right fonts for the vessel. If you're in 3ds Max, turn on edge faces so you can see the edge faces, okay? Which are the edges of each polygon, okay? Alright, so I'm going to go into the top view. I'm going to go in here and turn off highlight, turn blinds, and turn off highlights so we can see the model without the highlights from the specular settings. Turn on edge faces. Now I can see the edge faces. Now this is a separate geometry from the actual model, the saucer itself, but you can see the geometry matches up. It's how you create the text. Okay. For example, say I want to change this. I'll go into the saucer, select all the geometry. You don't have to select everything, just select all the geometry. Okay. For, you know, the area that this overlaps. So you can go right here, right here. You don't need this one, you don't need that one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Okay. Only the geometry. You might want to do this just to be on the safe side. Of course, you can do it on the safe side, but you don't need everything. You know, you don't need to take all the geometry in here and stuff. You don't need none of these, depending on where your registry's at. And once you have it all separated out, okay, let me open a new file here so I can do it quickly. Let me do a sphere just to make it simple. All right. Alright, you got your edge faces turned on so you can see your edge faces. You'll assume it'll be in an editable poly, depending on how old the model is. Sometimes it'll be an editable mesh. You can convert it to editable poly. And you go in here and you select your faces. Okay, and once you get done with all your faces and stuff for the object, alright, then you'll come down here and do detach, but you don't want to just hit detach and okay. You want to do detach as clone, okay, and then hit okay. That way you have a separate object which is the same exact faces, but you are not detaching it from this, you're not detaching those faces from the sphere, so the sphere still has all the faces that it needs, okay. And so now you're going to hide everything with the sphere and the geometry that you have, okay? And say, and of course this will be just a rough cut, okay? Say you create a text or a box or a cylinder or something. So I'm going to create a tube. Alright, create a tube. Okay, once you have your text created, you go and you extrude it so it, you know, is extruded so it's a 3D three-dimensional object rather than just a flat plane of text. You know, using, you convert it to editable poly, select everything, go into your, you know, face mode or polygon mode, and you select all that, then you hit extrude and extrude it out. And of course, if you want, you can cap the other end, but for the purposes of this, you really don't need to cap the other end because each end will go through the geometry. There won't be geometry. So I'm going to slide it over. Okay, let me shrink this down a little bit so it's not as big. Okay, and we'll move this up so it's here. Okay, you can see it's through the geometry. Alright, now this part's the tricky part. Okay, in terms of, which one to use, okay? So you'll go to create compound ProBooling. I'm not sure if all versions of Macs have it. I know if you have at least 2011, it has ProBooling, but I don't know if any previous versions of Macs have ProBooling. You'd have to check. If not, you might be able to get away with booling. You can do ProBooling, okay? What you're gonna do, and see this one still because I don't use it often enough, is you'll do, I think it's either imprint or cookie, okay? And then you're gonna pick your cylinder, okay? So now that you picked your cylinder, you have it cut into the object, okay? Now the higher polygon count, you know, the smoother the cut will look and stuff like that, and the smoother it'll work, okay? So now that you have it cut into there, okay? So for example, we're gonna clone this. Okay. Let's do this, make this a little interesting. We're gonna clone it, and I'm gonna move it forward a little bit. I'm gonna change the color so we can see it. And I'm gonna change the inner radius to radius 1, and then I'm gonna take radius 2 and bring it all the way down to 0. Okay, so we have this separately, okay? And then I'm going to hide this, and then I'm gonna go back to our boolean and pick this object, okay? Now that we have the object here, then I'm just gonna right click on it and hit convert back to an editable poly. All right, and then you'll just go through and delete all the faces that you don't need. You might have to do some cleaning up in case something kind of gets cut, okay? Because see, the weird geometry kind of doesn't make it a clean cut because of the low polyness of the sphere. But if you have a high poly object, the cut will look cleaner, okay? So now we have it perfect, you know, in terms of this, okay? And now I'm gonna change this from green to another color so we can see it separate from the sphere, okay? Now I'm gonna unhide the sphere. Now you can see the geometry, you know, granted, the low polyness of the geometry I'm using doesn't, you know, make a smooth cut. But if you had a higher poly sphere and stuff like that, the higher your polygons, the easier it is. And you can increase the polygons for certain areas. You know, you could go in and increase the amount of polygons and stuff. There's a lot of features in Macs, the Slate, that you can use when it comes to increasing polygons and stuff like that. I don't really use it since I'm a modeler mostly. But if I go into edges here, all right, and hit loop, or you select two of these, and then you go into loops, and then you do, you know, you can flow connect, okay. Example, do loop, then do flow connect. Alright. It kind of smooths, it kind of adds geometry there, as you can see. When I remove it, okay, you see flat, you know. And you can do all kinds of things with the Slate, but I don't use it that often. Okay? So, and of course, you know, if you go like this, and then hit loop, then flow connect, okay, you just smoothed out your sphere, okay, and then you can do loop rings, and then flow connect, okay, and you can smooth it right on down, okay, but I'm going to remove this for the purposes of the tutorial since it would make our geometry not match up. But anyway, now that you have this, okay, I'm going to select it. Select the faces. Let me extrude it a little bit. Okay. You can do by polygon, local normal, or by group. I'm going to just extrude it just a little bit so it's out from the sphere. Okay? And then I'm going to close that. And we're going to go to compound. You can do just regular Boolean for this if you want, or you can do Pro Boolean. Okay? And don't select imprint this time unless you want to. And now I'm going to just do subtraction and pick the cylinder. Okay? And now you have a nice little interesting feature here. And you do the same thing with the text. You extrude it with the imprint or cookie, whatever I did earlier in the video, to get this. Okay? That way you cut into the geometry you just detached without removing it. Then you remove all the extra around it, because if you don't do the imprint or cookie, whichever one that is, it'll cut the text into the geometry, and that's not what you want. It'll remove the text from the geometry and make you be able to see through it, like if you want to shine a light through it and create sort of like a little array look. But you want to do imprint or cookie, just rewind the video, and then you'll just delete all the geometry around your text so that it just leaves the text, and then you just extrude it a little bit or move it up a little bit, you know 0.2 or 0.3 up from where it's at, so it doesn't conflict with the geometry below it, like I did for the edge here. But now if I turn the edge loops off, you can kind of see it's not smooth because of how, low poly this is. But if I were to turn this upside down, we almost get like a Klingon torpedo tube look, here. But that's the basic idea of how to do it. And of course, sometimes you might have to do a little bit of correcting, like for example, okay, this kind of got skewed down here. Okay, so let me constrain to edge. That way when you move it, it'll move along just that edge. Okay. Alright. Let me do local so it's alright. Now the geometry will change because of the way that this is. Okay, if you watch closely, the shading kind of changes. As I move the vertices, it's hard to see. But that's basically what I did is, say I wanted to bring it and line it to this, okay? I just take and slid it up and kind of, on the text it was easier because it was a straight line for the L. And I just moved it into a straight line and deselected it. And now my L for the name looked perfect. At least in the sense of what I wanted it to look like. But no, that's basically, you would just have to correct a few things if you have some, just your basic cleanup for stuff. But I hope this helps in cutting text into objects. So they kind of hug it, You can do things like conform and stuff like that, which is a modifier and stuff like that. But, to me it's always been easier to just detach a section of geometry as a clone and cut into it with the imprint or cookie or whatever it is with Pro Boolean, and then just delete the geometry, extrude the text after you delete all the unnecessary polygons, and extrude it just a little bit. You don't want to create, big towering letters like the 20th Century Fox type thing. You just want to create just a little bit of difference between the saucer or whatever your text is on and the text, so you don't get that flickering and stuff. Or you can move the geometry slightly away from the object. For example, okay, hide this, okay. For example, you can extrude it like this, okay? Or you can kind of nudge it, center it on the object, okay? and you can kind of move it away from the geometry. Okay. Okay, but not too much, because you don't want to create, you know, too much of a separation between the two. And of course, if you want, you can turn shadows off, cast shadows off on that, so it doesn't cast shadows onto your hull. Because as far as we're concerned, the text is part of the saucer. It's painted onto the saucer. Okay. And of course, you can extrude it, and it'll extrude, you know, against the hull as well, so you won't have to worry about one edge being higher than the other. So that's basically it. I hope this helps, and I'll talk to you guys later.